Okay, so today we are going to start a new chapter. Which chapter? We have discussed about separation of substances. Separation of substances. Okay, so we have discussed last class. Yes or no? So what do you mean by separation? Who can say? What do you mean by separation? Yeah, Rudra say. Organize, huh?
To convert unuseful
to useful things. Any other? Yeah, Adi? Into two parts. Okay. Simply, if you will be think about or say about the separation, remove one thing from another. Okay, remove one thing from another. Okay, so remove one thing from another. Okay, so what do it mean? Now suppose take the example of the rice, chawal. Okay, so some of the stones already added in the rice, yes or no? When we will get or when we will separate, when we will separate the stones from the rice, yes or no? So separation means to remove one thing from another. Okay, so why we need separation? Why we need separation? Okay, now for the two things. Why? Now to get useful substances. To get useful substances, okay. And another is to remove unuseful substances. Very good. Okay, so separation is required. Why? Now to get the useful substances, to remove the unuseful substances. That same particular example, if you are taking rice and stone, rice are useful and stones are unuseful. So we are separating the two things. Okay, then come about the substances, the many things present in our surroundings. From them, the substances are two types. What are they? Now first is the pure substance, another is the mixture. First is the pure substance, another is the mixture. Okay. So substances are two types. What are they? Now first is the pure substance. Another is mixture. Okay, so what do you mean by pure substance? Some part, yes, say, Ishman. One particle, very good. Okay, so suppose when we are purchasing some of the gold or diamond, we are telling that it is pure gold, pure diamond. Pure means it is made by the single particle or same type of particle. Okay, so pure substance means the substance which are made by same type of particles, that known as the pure substances. Okay, example, you can take the gold, we have discussed already, gold, diamond, etc. Okay, then come about the mixture. Actually, that discuss about the two things. Actually, sir, mixture means we are eating in our as a dry food, and in our school canteen, that is a mixed veg, somehow we are giving, also telling that mixture. But here is the another mixture. So when we are telling the mixture, suppose take the example of our school canteen, that mixed veg mixture. Why we are telling that is mixture? Now because it is the made by different type of vegetables. Yes or no? So that it is a mixture. Then second is, we are eating dry food as the mixture. Biscuit mixture, we are telling that. Okay, Aishman give biscuit with him now also. Okay, he is eating. Okay, so that is the biscuit mixture and another is mixture. Why we are telling that is mixture? Now in that thing also the different type of things are there. Yes or no? So that known as the mixture. Okay. So but here what do you mean by mixture? Now mixture means when two or more substances or two or more particles they combine together, they join together, they form the mixture. Okay. So what will you write? Now mixture means the substance says which are made up of
one or more than two particles.
Yes, very good. Two or more than two particles, that known as the mixture. Then what will be the example of mixture? Now first will be the air. Okay, because from standard 3 or 4 we are reading about that air is the mixture of gases. The several gases are there, water particles are there, dust particles are there. So that the air is the first mixture. Then second take the example sea water. Okay, so sea water, what is the taste of sea water? Salty, saline. Okay, so sea water also another example of mixture. Why? Because when two or more substances will be mixed together, they form the substance that known as the mixture. And your tea, suppose in home your mother making the tea also one type of mixture. Okay,
tissue?
Yeah,
tissue.
Which tissue? Our cell tissue. Okay, actually our when the cell mix, they form the tissue. Okay, so single type. So these are the things, one about the substances are pure substances and mixture. But our chapter is the separation is substances. So how we will separate the substances from one another? See, we'll discuss about the three stages. What are they? Now first we'll discuss the methods how we will separate solids from the another solid. Solid from solid. Then we'll discuss about the methods which are involved to separation of solid, insoluble solid particles from the liquid. And last we'll discuss about the methods which are the liquids mixed with or soluble solids which are found in the liquids. So these are the three stages and different methods we will know about how we can separate them. So first we will discuss about how we will separate the solids from another solid. Okay, so write separation of solid from solid particles. So separation of solids from solid. Okay, so to separate the solid from another solid, some steps are involved in it. What are they? The first process is the hand picking method. Okay, second is the sieving. Third, we'll know about the threshing. And next, we'll see winnowing. Okay, so these are the four methods which are involved to separate the solids to another solid. Okay, solid from solid. So first is the hand picking method. Hand means hand. Okay, and picking means pick karna, leana. Okay, so hand picking method means the process by which the separation of solids from another solid by using your hand, that known as your hand picking method. Okay, we have already discussed example, that is the picking of the stones from the rice. picking up the stone from the rice. That is the example of hand picking. उसको हम हाथ में करते हैं. Yes or no? Next, take the example. Suppose we have given different color of the balls. Different color of the balls. If I will say that separate them, so how you will say? You will take the by your hand. You will maybe the colors are different, so that you will put at the different groups. But you will be catch it by your hand. You will be put it in the bucket or basket. Okay. So that also your hand picking method. Okay. It means hand picking method means by hand the separation of solid substances from another solid substances by using your hand. That known as your hand picking method. Okay. Then come about the sieving method. What do you mean by sieving method? Sieving means actually this sieving method mostly using during the construction time. Construction time means this plaster time. Okay, actually different shape of stones, sands are there. In the sand, some of the big stones are there. Yes or no? That stones cannot be used in the plaster. So that we have to separate the stones from that sand. Okay, and that's if we think about the sieving method. Sieving method uses when the solid substances are different in size. Okay, sand size is different, stone size is different. Okay, that time this sieving method uses. Okay, like when you are doing tea, you are purifying or you are filtration, when doing the filtering by your filtering or something like that. That time also we are separating the sand which are in different in shapes. Okay, that is your sieving method. Then come about the threshing method. What do you mean by threshing? Now actually threshing method, now you are all are living in the town. So probably very less students are there. Those are watching the rice cultivation, rice agriculture. Have you seen? Yeah, very good. You have seen rice cultivation, rice agriculture. You have seen. Have you seen the harvesting time? Have you seen? Yes. Have you seen? Very good. So what happened? Now when the rice will be ripening, the farmers will be caught that. Rice plant. Okay, that was happening in the previous time. Somehow it is happening now also. But now actually different machines are there. No farmers are required to cut the rice plant. The machine will be come to the field. It will be cut to the rice plant. And one side will be rice grains. Another side will be the stalks. But in the previous time, the small machines are using. Okay, hand machines like that. Using at that time, what happened? Now the farmers, they're separating the grains from the stalks. Stalks means nada. Okay, so the threshing means the process by which the removal of the grains from the stalks. Okay, that means that known as the threshing. By the machine or by using the manually, that known as your threshing method. Okay, actually the threshing and winnowing, they are correlated. After the threshing, winnowing must be required. Winnowing means to separation of the lighter materials from the heavier materials. Suppose when during the threshing time, that may be using by the machine or that may be the manual method, whatever method you may be use, the farmers may be use. What happened? Now some of the dust particles will be there. Some of the small stalks will be there in the rice grains. So we will require to separate it. Why? Now because when we are taking the rice, only we require the rice, no need of the stalks, no need of the dust particles. Yes or no? So that the winnowing is must be required. Winnowing means the separation of lighter materials from the heavier materials by using the wind, that known as your winnowing method. Okay, that one is your winnowing method. Means the separation of the lighter materials. Lighter materials means the dust particles, the small stalks which are present in the rice grains, Okay, so we have to separate it. How will separate? Now by the force of wind. By the force of wind. That process is known as the wind. Okay, so these are the four process which are involved to separation of solid from another solid. Okay, first is the hand picking method where we can use our hand to separate them. Next is the sieving method which are used in the different size. Hand picking means by using the hand. Okay, then come about threshing. Threshing means separation of stalks, separation of grains from the stalk, from the stalks. Okay, by using the machine or manually, that may be. Then come about the winnowing. Winnowing means the separation of lighter materials
from heavier materials.
Very good. From heavier materials. Okay, so these are the four processes which are involved in the separation of the solids. Okay, so next class what we will see? Now how you will separate the insoluble solid particles from the liquid. Suppose we have added the sand into the water, how we will separate them? In the next class we will see that thing, that part, and next we will see how we will separate the soluble insoluble particles from the liquids. Okay, so prepare the notes, or next class we will write the notes of this. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.